sooner than you think. 2017, we're going to elect a new governor. Governor Christie, one way or the other, whether he's headed off to the White House or onto his next career, either way, a new governor will be in Trenton. And already the Democrats, confident after Tuesday's election win in the Assembly, are eyeing Drumthwacket, saying it will likely be a Democrat. Now, I'm not going to predict anything. I would certainly say the odds are there. And you've heard about Jersey City Mayor Steve Phillip. You've heard about Senate President Steve Sweeney. You've certainly heard about Ray Lesniak, who is a friend of the show, who comes on and he's thinking about running. So you got a lot of big names out there of Jersey politicians. One name you may have not heard of is Titus Pierce. Now, Titus Pierce, I met him the other day while he was walking to an interview. And he is on the phone right now. Titus, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning, Bill. How's everything going?
Good. So first of all, did your car get fixed? Because I know you've been walking around the state as you campaign for governor because car's in the shop.
The car is still going to stay in the shop for a little bit longer.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. But so give me real quick, why are you running for governor? And why do you think an unknown political newcomer would have any possibility of becoming the Democratic nominee in 2017?
Things happen all the time, and in particular in the Democratic Party. It's going to be a toss-up here in New Jersey. I'm running to fix the credit, to fix the commercial exchange between the state, and to grow the local economy. New Jersey is a $677 billion economy. It's the seventh largest in the United States and the 22nd largest in the world. And we have a unique opportunity here if we have a businessman, a business-centric leader that would drive the economy forward. You know, we only do business with about 5 to 6 global countries right now, Ireland, Israel, and a few others. It's very critical and important that we have a New Jersey leader that will, you know, get our global agenda.
All right, now, Titus, polls do matter at some level because at least it gives you an indication of where you are. You told me the other day when I met you that that you looked at this from the perspective of your winning.
Correct.
All right, explain that. You got about 30 seconds. Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you right now, when you sit down and you see 6% to Fulop, 3% to Murphy, and only 14% to Sweeney, and then you see the unknown at 26 and 57 and 74, those were all percentages of opportunity. And that's where I say, if they're saying unknown or another candidate, I'm the only other candidate out there. I'm in every single town. That means it's me. So although I may not have the publicity and the cash on hand today, it means I'm definitely formidable in every single county. And I'm going to continue to run like that.
All right. And you are also an Iraq War veteran.
You better believe it. I served with 4th Infantry Division, and I served one of the best forces ever, and I loved every day of it.
All right, Titus. I like the idea that there are outsiders out there potentially taking advantage of the fact that we have so many independent voters in New Jersey. Good luck to you. I will check in with you periodically. Stay in touch with me for sure. And good luck as you walk the streets trying to get votes.